Hello, this is ELB. Let's get back to work. So, last time we got some weapon switching working. Let's take a quick look at that. Also, yes, I just opened a drink. Okay, let's see here. Pick these up. Get in here. Equip the whip. Equip the scythe. Right now we're punching. Real simple punch. If I tap, we'll switch to the whip. Not the best looking whip, honestly. Huh. No, it was fine. Anyhow. So, what I'm thinking I'd like to work on next is maybe armor. I don't entirely know what that's gonna look like equipment wise. Here, let's open this again real quick. So we got right hand, offhand, and tools. Let's pick up the tools. Some sort of spot for maybe it would go weapons, tools, then weapon armor, then tools. I don't know. Oh yeah, we also got this guy. We shouldn't be able to switch like that, though. That's a problem. So in order to start this, we are going to need to open up. Thank you. Okay. Get this going. Let's see, tools, equipment, armor, tools, materials. do this real quick, because why not? We don't need to have a belt for the armor, of course, since we're not going to be switching armor in the middle of a mission. And mission was not really the right word to use for that. But still. What am I looking for here exactly? Not totally sure yet. Right now, I have no idea what the what do you call it? I'm not totally sure, like, how many pieces of armor it will take. Maybe upper, lower, and helmet, or maybe, I don't know, helmet, arms, torso, hips, lower. Like, that's how Monster Hunter does it, right? Dark Souls is 4 pieces, right? Yeah, I think it is. Being very good at keeping focused today. That was a lie, of course. Or sarcasm. Sarcasm? What the hell? Where did it... The hell is it? Come on. There we go. So what I'm thinking is, helmet, torso, legs. Oh, we can do arms as well, because we're going to be looking at the fists anyhow, right? When punching. So... Create group. Armor. See SPR. We're going to make it 16 by 16. And this is going to be a simple test helmet, so like a fucking rice ball. Looking up a picture to use. There, that looks enough like a helmet. You'll be SPR item HUD. Armor, torso. So something like yeah, it sort of looks like a breastplate, whatever. Item, HUD, armor, arm. Looking up images to help me out here. Thinking something that kind of something that kind of looks like that, I guess. You know what? I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Let's see, the coloring is that. So I will do this. Create a layer called color. Snag the color. Fill it up. There we go. Okay, now for the final one. Actually, you're going to be SPR item HUD armor legs. Let's see, this one shouldn't be too difficult. Just, oh, come on. This is looking like Minecraft. Oh well. There. Four super basic things. Okay, so SPR, item, outside, armor, legs. Arms, torso, head. Nope. Oh, come on. There we go. No, come on. We don't need that. We don't need a weapon sprite. Don't know if we'll keep a description. We don't need any of this. Okay. Up, armor, torso, Almost there. There we go. Let's try picking these up. Okay, cool. It's not actually going to affect anything yet, but at least it's a start getting the data into the inventory. So, now that we're able to actually pick up the armor, we need to be able to see it, don't we? So let's see here. We're looking for not creatures. No, it isn't creatures, isn't it? Main GUI, weapons menu, tools menu, player inventory. Going to be changing a lot of stuff around. Let's see, so we should be able to do... There's the error. Then player menu minus minus. If player menu is equal to 2. No, that's not going to work. If player menu is equal to 3. Oh, here we go. So we're checking to see if it is within these values, and then we can finally do the minus minus. Okay, so that should work. The only problem is that we're not actually drawing anything there. So let's try and fix that real quick. So we can steal this stuff real quick. We just gotta make it say that. Then we need to make this say that. Hopefully it looks okay, although button presses are still going to be screwing up, I think. We might even get some errors. That's funny. Okay. Well, no errors at least. What was the order that we just went in? I don't even know. So let's see, that's actually six. I'm thinking I'm going to have to change the actual everything else to like a grid format. Might be a bit better, I don't know. Let's see. Get rid of you. That should be fine. We're looking for that. There we go.
Let's see how this looks.
So not quite there yet. Let's fix that. Fix that. Oh, wait a moment. This should work. Let's see. Hopefully. Okay, so it seems like the X button still needs some fixing. X button. Will that fix it? I think so. Yeah, I think so. Wait. Okay.
Forgive my yawniness. Like
10 a.m. I got a couple hours before work. There is a pretty big gap in between recording for this one. There we go. Okay, cool. So we got the switch to work. Now we need to actually be able to show the armor. But I do think I want to change it to a grid system rather than a list system. Because here, I'm gonna open it again real quick. Anyhow, it makes a little bit more sense. You're able to go through everything a little bit quicker. Like, if I turned these into 16 by 16 and then had them outlined, then don't know. Think it would look a little bit better. So let's figure out exactly how we're gonna do this. There we go. Is there any other working code? Nope. Cool. Let's try doing this. Oh, wait a moment. We had scrolling, didn't we? I always spell that wrong. There we go. Okay, so we're going to be assuming that each row will have a maximum possibility of 8. Then we'll do another one. What would we say, like MGX plus 1 and then GY plus 20? Okay, let's try that. So with no weapons, it shouldn't draw anything. With a couple weapons, it should draw something. Well, that's not right at all. Oh. Let's try that. Should work a bit better. Nothing, that's good. Good still. So I'm going to test something real quick. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'll pick up all the sides. It should only have one row. Pick up the whip. It should have two rows. Nope. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Oh, my bad. I can't math, apparently. There we go. All right. So there should be a math function that shows us what's left over of a division. Can't remember what it's called, though. What the hell was it? Wasn't in vector functions, was it? Hold on, I'll just look it up. Wow, I just realized I wasn't recording that at all. I'm stupid. In any case, I ended up using this frac, which will give me the decimal. I just multiply it by 8, which should give me the leftover since I knew what was originally divided by right here. And then I did this, so let's give that a shot and see if it works. Okay, so we open, nothing, grab one, there should only be one, nope. Okay, it's not right at all. So what went wrong? Let's try that. There should only be one, there's one, there should only be two, there should only be three, there's three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Ooh, that's not good. Right, pick up that. Okay. Well, we got closer at least. So what happened? Mm. You know, what if I just cheated, honestly? Like, it's gonna feel like cheating. Well. This is going to be terrible. There we go. Draw rectangle. No, not draw rectangle. Draw background. Background will be BKG. Inventory grid. X will be. Then var y. Start plus 16 times fair column Okay. Bit simpler than the other one. Let's see if it works. None. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There we go. And 9. Yeah, no, that works. Oh, man. Okay. Okay, so now that we got this, I guess we gotta just draw the weapons, right? That makes sense. So we can easily reuse this repeat for the, you know, actual items. So Or what is it called? The global.inventory right hand is a list. And then the position will be var count. I'm looking for HUD sprite, SPR item HUD weapon scythe. So yeah, HUD sprite. X will be that. So let's give that a shot, and then I think I'm gonna have to be done for now and go to work. Maybe. I don't know, I only got a few minutes. Crip, crap, crup. Not set before reading it. Did I spell something wrong? No, I'm dumb. That was the problem. There we go. And there's more than enough space for description or anything else necessary. Cool. What if I did that though? Would that add just like a little tiny space between them? Because that would be nice. It does! Okay, cool. Okay. I'm done for now. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day.